Do you have to have a supercalifragilisticexpialidocious hi-hat to play the drums? No. But it's cool. All right, quit messing around.
Playing a hi-hat with your foot is that it's like the hype man. It's like your hype man going, yeah, I like what you're doing. Yeah. So how do you get there? How do you be able or get to the point where you can play beats with the hi-hat with your foot? Well, think about what's happening with your foot while you're playing. I'm hitting this, and then I'm hitting this. At the same time, I'm hitting that together, right? So this lesson is recommending that you start out practicing all the downbeats with your foot on all the beats that you know. Not the ands, because you're gonna run into problems with the ands playing your bass drum in different configurations if you're not able to play the downbeats in context first. So go to the grid, do one at a time. What's easier than four things? Three things. What's easier than three things? Two things. Easier than two things? One thing. What's easier than one thing? Nothing. Let's just go eat a sandwich. I'm just kidding. All right. Four times in a row on the one, counting to four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. On the two. Two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. On the three. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two. On the four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. One, two, three, four. You got it. Am I serious? Yes, I'm serious about playing that. You want to practice that through all the beats you know. Let's take a basic eighth note rock beat and then play on the one. Try to add the hi-hat with a snap on the one. Now I'm going to try the two, the one and the two. Try the three. Now all four. If you can't do that, back it up, slow down. Have the patience to get all four of these incorporated in all of your beats before you do the ands. But if you do all four of them, you're gonna have a leg up on any of the ands that you'll ever wanna do, right? Then I would say maybe try practicing all of them or ones that are uncomfortable. The truth is I did not go from this to this. But if I had to do it over again, I would practice this. Why? Because it fills a bunch of holes. It fills all the different possibilities of where my hands are gonna be while my foot's moving. So I recommend that. I didn't do that, but I recommend that. Now I can, but the next thing I worked on was this on the ands, right? And so that's the next thing you should probably work on if you wanna get there. Play a basic rock beat, then add all the beats you've ever learned in progression as far as the degree of difficulty. So let's play a basic rock beat and play on all the ands. What's easier than four things? You get it. Okay, so we're gonna go like this. now that I've got my basic beat, try to go more progressive, like what's more difficult, or what was the next beat that I learned. And you're on your way to doing the more complicated beats. Oops. The other thing about the hi-hat is practice using your hand, your left hand over here to do the nut. We're gonna push our foot up and down, right? I'm gonna push my foot down a little bit and then hold it, then use my left hand to reach over and tighten this, then let go of my foot. It should lift the cymbal up. If it doesn't, start again. Now, the cymbal should be open enough to get some velocity and make a snapping sound. If it's not, you might wanna make it more open. But then again, you don't want it so open that you can't hold it tight and play the hi-hat with your foot holding it tight to make a staccato sound with the tip of the stick. Anyway, I hope that helps you play the hi-hat with your foot a little bit more or better. If you have any questions, comment, or let me know, keep time, have fun, and be yourself.